It's important to protect our water resources while we're working on a construction site. The water resources might not always be visible, but the pollutants will travel long distances through the pipes and sewer network to reach those lakes and rivers. One thing that we can do is use best management practices and good housekeeping to help keep that soil in place. You can minimize erosion by phasing your project. Disturb only the areas you are working in rather than the whole site. Once the grading is done in that area, use temporary or permanent erosion controls to stabilize it. Here you can see we have existing grass, which helps filter out some of those pollutants before it even gets to our silt fence, perimeter control. Stockpiles are common on all construction sites, and it's a challenge to keep them contained. One thing is to place them onto a grass or weedy surface so that you have a perimeter of vegetation around it. If you place a stockpile on a hard surface, in a rain event, the water coming along that hard surface can start to erode your stockpile and wash it away. Tracking soils onto the street or sidewalk from vehicles and equipment entering the construction area is an aesthetic as well as a pollutant problem. There are a few options available to help you minimize tracking, such as rock or mulch construction entrances or portable mats. When soil is washed away on a construction site, it is prone to ending up in our lakes and rivers. So rock entrances will keep materials from the construction site from being tracked out off of your construction site into the road. To create a rock entrance, you install some washed, maybe 1 to 3 inch gravel, maybe a 6 inch thick layer. Ideally, it would be maybe 50 feet long or to fill the area where your vehicles are operating. Using a geotextile fabric underneath it, as the vehicles sit on that rock, the tires are not picking up other pollutants and dirt and tracking those out into the street. So another construction entrance that's available, if you don't have rock available to you, is a mud mat product. This is basically a portable and reusable sort of construction entrance. You can see it's basically a geotextile fabric with some reinforcement wood ribs inside of it. Vehicles will park on this, drive on this. The ribs can help bounce some of the debris off of the tires and also give you a non-erodible surface between the tires and the soils below. The mud mat product has clips to link multiple mats together if you have a wider or a longer drive surface that you need. So you can use this to access maybe an area which is grassed and you don't want to disturb the grass. You could lay these out for really as long as you'd need. Even with all of our management practices in place, we're still probably going to have debris washing off the site and ending up in the street, which means we have to sweep. Although your site may be small, the cumulative impacts of pollutants from improperly managed construction sites contributes to the degradation of our lakes and streams. Do your part to keep the pollution on your site and out of our waters.